So let's take up numericals itself. Write down. The moon is observed from two diametrically opposite points A and B on the earth. So here is the earth. Draw the earth like this. From two diametrically opposite points A and B, you are observing the moon. Okay? We are treating moon as a point object. Okay, moon as a point object. Let's say moon is here. You are observing from two diametrically opposite points the moon. Okay, how it will be? You are observing like this from point A, and then from point B it is like that. Okay, that's how you are observing. Okay, the angle subtended by the moon by two directions of observation, one direction is this first observation direction, this is the second observation direction. Okay, the angle subtended, this angle which is subtended, don't use calculators, okay, don't use it, otherwise later on you will have yourself to blame, you will not be able to calculate anything in the exam. Last year also it was very calculation intensive, JEE Mains, I'm talking about, and 2014 also it was very calculation intensive. So if you don't have practice to calculate, you're gone. Okay, and being good with number is an art. Okay, it's something which is which doesn't come to everyone. Okay, it's an art. Don't think that it's a donkey's job. There are so many donkeys' job, but calculating, being good with number is not a donkey's job. It is something which will really help you a lot later on also. Some of the highest paying jobs are for people who are good with numbers. Okay, so this angle is 1 degree 54 minutes. The diameter of earth is 1.276 into 10 raised to the power 7 meters. This is the diameter of Earth. Okay? You need to calculate the distance of Moon from the Earth. Understood the question?
Yes.
First thing is you have to convert the angle in radians. Then only you can say that is equal to arc length divided by radius. Done? Theta is 1 degree 54 minutes. How to convert this in radians?
So 1 degree is
1.745. 1 degree is
1.745.
Minus 2 then?
54
seconds. Multiply with 54.
No, plus 54 by 16.
Plus
54 into 2.91.
You can say 54 by 16 into this, or if you know what is 1 minute in terms of radians, which is what?
2.91
into 10 raised to power minus 4. You can get this in terms of radians. All of you understood this one? How many radians you will get here? How many radians?
3.15.
No, radians is 0.33036.
See, you're not able to calculate. Yeah. You're not able to calculate and get and arrive at the same thing.
So this is 0.3315
3.3155 into 10 to the power minus 4.
3.3155. 10 is power?
Minus 4.
Minus 4, you said.
Yeah.
It cannot be.
Okay.
Look at this. This itself is 10 to minus 3. Order.
No, sir. It's 0.03306.
So it is sad that you think that calculation is something which is very boring, or it is a donkey's job. You're not able to do the donkey's job. So donkey will be proud.
0.03306.
3.365 to 10 to the power minus 2.
Okay, I'll tell you the correct one.
Yeah.
It is 3.32 into 10 to the minus 2.
Yeah, we just calculated further.
Yeah. You have this American accent,
right? No.
So can we leave it as pi and take pi as 3.14 in the next
What?
So can we take the degrees in terms of pi and take that pi as 3.14 while doing the calculation?
Yeah, pi is 3.14. You can do that. But why to? You know, complicated. I mean, why to increase the calculation? You should, if you remember what is 1 degree, what is 1 minute, you can just use it. Otherwise, you're telling me you'll first derive what is 1 degree in terms of radians, what is 1 second in terms of radians, and then use it. Yeah, you can do that. Definitely. Okay? We did just that to find out how much is 1 degree and how much is 1 minute. Alright? Now, you have the angle in terms of radians. Can you calculate the distance of moon from the earth?
Yeah.
By the way, these are the true values.
So is the distance 3.84 into 10 to the power of 8 meters?
Yeah,
I
got that.
Hmm.
Yeah.
So let's say this is the distance. This distance is small d. So what can I say? Capital D divided by small d is what? Arc length divided by radius. This should be equal to this angle. So how much you got small d as?
So I can get 3.84.
3.84 into 10 raised to 8.
10 power 8.
10 is for 8
meters.
It is actually around 20 times the diameter of the earth. The distance of moon from the earth. Okay, let's do one more numerical. All of you get it right. Only mistake you can make is calculation error, but nobody gives a damn whether you make calculation error or some other error, conceptual error. It still get minus one only. Understood? It's the exam you're writing, they don't care how you're getting the answer. Okay? They just care about the final answer, nothing else. Understood, all of you? Okay, next question. Alright, write down. Sun's angular diameter. Sun's angular diameter is 1920 minutes. Okay? The distance of Sun from the Earth. Distance of Sun from the Earth is 1.496. Oh, you remember these values? This is the distance of Earth from the Sun. Okay? How far the Jupiter is from the Mars?
Further.
Further
than that.
Not from the Sun.
Yeah, it's further than this.
Yeah.
You need to find diameter of the Sun. How much is the diameter of this Sun?
So what is the angular diameter?
It's basic.
Angle subtended by the diameter of this Sun. The most obvious thing.
So but subtended where?
On Earth.
On Earth.
Where it should be. Where are the humans?
Okay.
Sun is bigger. I understand what you're saying. But then treat Earth as a point and Sun as a bigger object. See, it is the Sun's diameter that is making angle. and it will be making angle at a particular location of the earth. There are some approximations, so you might be wondering it is from the bottom surface of the sun or from the center of the sun. More or less they are same, because the distance of earth from the sun is much larger than any dimension of earth or sun.
How much are you allowed to approximate?
The
third one you can do.
1 or 2 decimal points, that's it. Don't be like, you know, 2.367953 into. Doesn't mean anything. Stop at 1 or 2 decimal points. Because these values are approximate only, they are not the exact value. So why you are calculating up to 10 decimal places? That is approximate value itself. Anybody got the answer?
Yes, 8.4.
You got 8.4. The first step is to draw the diagram itself. That is wrong, which you got.
So it's 5.89 into 10 to the power 11.
No.
Maybe how can it be?
Oh wait, I'm sorry about it. In the question it is written minutes, but actually it is in the solution they are treating it seconds. So it is seconds. 19207. Sorry about that.
R slash. Can we just keep it as
if minutes? All of you are getting right answers. Oh my god.
You just
there's a multiplying factor, right? So just multiply and divide.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, now that you know it is correct, all of you should get it the right answer. Okay, so this is the diagram. This is the sun. This is, you can say, earth. The diameter of the sun. Makes 1920 seconds, the angle. This is diameter D, and this is the distance of the sun from the earth. So how we'll go about this? Capital D divided by small d should be equal to what? 1920
into 4.2.
Good. 10 to minus?
6.
6 or 4?
6.
So 6?
I got this divided by 6.
I said 6.
Alright. So, you know the small d value, you can find the capital D. Okay? And it is 1.39 into 10 to the 9. Diameter of the sun is 1.39 into 10 to the power 9. Meters, which is around 100 times the diameter of the earth. Okay.
So you can convert the seconds to minutes.
Then you have to convert minutes into radians also. Okay, you have to use SI units.
Wait, what did you guys get?
4.6 into 10 to the power
9. I got 1.39, but not into 10 power 9.
I know.
Mess up the tens. So, oh wait, no. That,
I got this.
Alright.
Yeah, I got the tens.
Okay, so all of you understood how we can use the property of angle to determine the large distances. Okay. So this is the calculation of large distances. We are indirectly calculating the distance, large distances, by just using the definition of angles. Okay, now stop talking. Now we have to also come up with a method to calculate the small sizes, small lengths. Because the lengths we are dealing in physics, they are like this, you know. For example, size of a proton is 10 to the minus 15 meters. And distance of, or the diameter of observable universe is 10 to the power 26 meters. So we are dealing from 10 to the minus 15 to 10 to the power 26 meters. And we as humans can calculate only, let us say, from 10 to the power minus 5 meters, or 10 to the minus, directly I'm saying, directly using a scale or something, we can only calculate from 10 to the minus 4 or 10 to the minus 5 meters using screw gauge or things like that. To, let us say, directly if you want to calculate, let us take 1 kilometer, which is 10 to the power 3. So the range is from 10 to the minus 5 to 10 to the power 3 meters for direct measurement using scale or whatever. Okay, but the range we are dealing with in physics is 10 to the minus 15 to 10 to the power 26. Okay, so there are indirect methods to determine the large distances. There should be indirect method to determine the small distance also. Okay, you cannot put a scale to measure the distance of electron from the nucleus. Okay, there should be some indirect method like these. Okay, this method is for estimation of large distances. Okay, now there are various indirect methods. This is just one of the methods to find the large distances. Okay, so similarly, we are now talking about indirect method to measure the small distances. Okay, small distances as in size of a nucleus, size of a proton, or let us say size of an atom, things like that. Okay, so one particular method is in our syllabus because you can practically do that.